Before the class, I was feeling really, really nervous, but we kind of got to the first day of school and everybody was going around in a circle and saying like, oh, this is how many dives I've been on.
But many of us didn't have 12 dives all together under our belt before the class started as a whole. So it was definitely a little nerves, and you could tell everybody was nervous but excited. It puts you out of your comfort zone.
You definitely know which button fills their VC. One
spot. Diving is one of the most important tools for discoveries in marine science. And if we want to have a capable, thriving marine science program, then we need to be able to give this skill to our students.
Awesome. All right, looks like a little water.
Okay, got it.
You are out of air. Octopus breathe with Sarah.
We get into the pool so we can make sure that we all meet sort of the same minimum standard of diving skills. And then we take those skills into the ocean, and then we progress into learning scientific sampling techniques in the water.
They're probably a little nervous because this is the first time they're going to the bottom, 40 feet under the pier. It's a little dark. They've never done these skills before, most of them. So it's the first time they're going to be working on salvaging a weight with a lift bag. It's the first time they're going to be navigating using their compass for any, you know, significant distances in these type of conditions.
Okay, awesome.
You look good. Let's put on my gear.
Underneath the pier, you're kind of looking at the surface of the water, and I'm going through my mental checklist of like, is my air open all the way? Is my regulator in my mouth so that I can breathe? Is my buoyancy compensation device inflated so that I don't sink like a bag of rocks when I hit the water? And then you do your giant stride, which is kind of like a one big step, and then everything gets really quiet once you hit the water.
The first time that I went down next to the pier, it was pretty amazing. I'm next to this pier piling, trying to keep it in sight. We descend down. It was kind of easy that first dive to just kind of get distracted by all the marine life down there. The best way that I can explain it is it's like being in outer space or on a different planet, because it's really nothing like being on land.
We say if you can dive on the central coast, then you can dive anywhere. A lot of diving doesn't require the skill or training that you need to dive out here because it's colder temperatures, it's rougher conditions, the visibility is not so great a lot of the time. So if they are confident divers here, I feel confident that they can go and dive in the Caribbean or dive on the East Coast and do very, very well.
One of the most rewarding days in the class is our boat dive day. It's sort of the culmination of the class. The students have been looking forward to it and anticipating it for 2 to 3 weeks.
It'll be my first boat dive.
Oh, so excited.
We head out to an offshore reef, and the students are battling sometimes a little bit of anxiety, a little bit of seasickness. So there's a high level of excitement and of a little bit of anxiety at the same time.
We are right in front of Point Bouchon in the protected area. It's a beautiful dive site.
Taylor and I are going to go run a transect. We're going to do some benthic surveys for mobile invertebrates and possibly some fish transects.
A lot of classes teach you stuff that you've never learned before.
But at Cal Poly, we have learned by doing, so you get to do a lot of stuff you've never done before.
Make
sure
you're
fixed. There we go. Including a boat dive. I've been diving open water for 4 years and I've still never done a boat dive, so pretty sick.
So the students got in, they first jumped in, they kind of got pushed to the back of the boat. They're having to really push and swim hard to get up to drop down and descend down the anchor. And we were trying to encourage them that it was gonna be worth it, it was gonna be an amazing dive, and you could kind of see a little bit of hesitation in their eyes.
That first like 20 meters of water was super green and you could maybe see the end of your hand or like the end of your fins, and that was it. And then we dropped below that zone and it just kind of opened into like so many more feet of visibility. But to be under the water 52 feet, you can't see the surface of the water at all. You kind of look up and you see your bubbles just travel for forever until they just leave your sight. It's awesome.
One of the important things about our scientific diving class at Cal Poly is that this is a diving class for our science students. It is not a science class for our most avid scuba divers. And this is important because we're trying to give an important skill to our marine science students so that they can be better placed in the job market beyond Cal Poly.
I think that all of the opportunities that Cal Poly has given me to be in the field and experience what it's like to do actual field work as a marine scientist, I don't think I can even really fully understand the impact of that.
I feel really grateful that Cal Poly has a class like this for me to be able to experience science underwater, because I mean, what a treat to be able to say like, oh, I scuba dived for class over the summer. Like, not everybody gets to say that.